Good morning. If we could all please rise and welcome the graduating class of 2022.
Good morning. I would like to welcome town officials, school committee members, Superintendent Neef, administration, faculty, family and friends, and the class of 2022 to the commencement ceremonies today. Please remain standing for the opening ceremonies. At this time, I would like to welcome the Carver Fire Department Color Guard for the presentation of our colors. And I would also like to welcome the Carver Middle High School chorus to the front of the stage for the singing of our national anthem. This time I would like to welcome the Secretary of the Class of 2022, Isabella De Morales, to lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance. Please remain standing until the class of 2023 President Sidney Sheehan seats the class of 2022.
Sit now.
You may be seated. Thank you to the Carver Fire Department Honor Guard, to the Carver High School Chorus, and to Isabella, the Secretary of the Class of 2023, for opening our graduation ceremonies for 2022. On Thursday evening, we recognized several seniors at convocation ceremony for their academic excellence. We would like to take a moment to acknowledge the following individuals and scholarships that were not presented at that time. When your name is called, please stand to be recognized. Jay Peters received the Sousa Family Memorial Sousa Family Scholarship. And the following students received the Jake Town Memorial Scholarship: Gabby Tabaji, Libby Camadella, and Mike Crump. Congratulations and thank you to the scholarship donors for all your generosity and support for our seniors. Before I have the privilege of addressing the class of 2022, I would like to recognize the many people who have contributed to the success of our graduates. To the Carver Middle High School faculty, I truly appreciate all that you do for students of Carver Middle High School. On a daily basis, in your classrooms, it is that you that provides all of our students with tremendous opportunities to learn, to think, and to grow. Collaboratively and individually, you have given countless hours of your time and should take great pride in the accomplishments of the students on this stage. Thank you for your support and dedication. It seems appropriate at this time to take a moment and recognize two of our staff members who have retired or will be retiring at the end of this school year. Rose Driscoll and Mike Fracalossi. Our community is better for the time you've spent here. Your impact on the students of Carver Middle High School will forever leave an imprint with them and this community. To our guidance team, we can never thank you enough for your hard work and dedication through the last 4 years. We are all assured and confident these graduates today are ready for the next part of their journey. Your efforts have provided students with multiple post-high school opportunities, including college, the workplace, and the military. Thank you. To Mr. Antel, thank you for all you continue to do as the interim assistant principal at Carver Middle High School. You joined our team this spring and have quickly asserted yourself as a true leader. It is evident in your daily interactions that you care about the success of the students and the community. Thank you. Superintendent Neve, thank you for your support, your dedication to this community, and your consistent focus on the goal of improving teaching and learning for all students. Your presence at school activities does not go unnoticed, and your pride in Carver is evident. Thank you. To our administrative assistants, thank you for always making a great first impression for students, parents, and anyone visiting our offices in our building. In many ways, you are the face of Carver Middle High School. Your kindness and patience foster a supportive and caring environment. Thank you for all you do behind the scenes today and every day. To our senior class advisors, Mrs. Bertram, Mrs. Kilnap, and Mr. Rota, thank you for working to bring back the traditional senior events this year. The work that goes into your roles, especially this time of year, is monumental. But rest assured, these seniors appreciate what you have done for them in getting them to this point in their journey. Thank you. Thank you to Mr. Tunis and the Carver High School Band for your time and effort in providing all the music during the graduation week ceremonies. To our support staff, custodians, cafeteria staff, transportation, and monitors, I've always said that education is a team effort and you all play a vital role. Thank you for providing a safe and supportive learning environment for our students in your respective domains. Our graduates, through the generosity of many, have been awarded over $87,000 in scholarships donated from alumni, businesses, community, and memorial organizations. These scholarship donors and recipients can be found in your program. Can we please have a round of applause for all the generous scholarship donors? To the Carver community, thank you for your continued commitment and investment in our schools. You've always put education at the forefront of our community, and the students and staff of Carver Middle High School greatly appreciate it. And finally, to the parents and guardians, thank you for your devotion to your children and their futures. You're ultimately responsible for molding and shaping the students that stand before us today. Although the last few years may not have been a traditional high school experience, you were there when they needed you to provide support and guidance. Your efforts and dedication have played an instrumental role in the success of your children, and you should take great pride in their accomplishments. And finally, to the class of 2022, I want to start by saying thank you. Thank you for making me a better person, educator, and administrator. During the second half of my freshman year, your freshman year, I became interim principal. You had acquired quite a reputation, and it was my job to get to know you. Over the course of the next few months and years, as you grew, I did as well. We focused on the 95% rule and started to shift our culture based on trust and respect. Our confrontations became conversations, and we've developed meaningful relationships since. Ultimately, you have helped to shape the type of educational leader I am today, and for that, I am ever forever grateful. I'm sure you've heard this question many times over the last few weeks and or months. What are you doing next year? For some, the question comes with great excitement, but for others, it may be a source of anxiety. Am I making the right decision? Did I choose the right college? Am I ready to join the workforce, or is the military right for me? The truth is, there is no right answer. And each of your paths to success will look very different. Mine certainly did. When I graduated high school in June of 1989, I had not committed to a college or attained a full-time job. I was unsure what to do, and my parents were getting concerned. With September soon approaching, my father encouraged me to attend Massasoit Community College to study architecture. Like George Costanza, I always wanted to be an architect. In 2 years, I had attained my associate's degree and was accepted into the bachelor's program at Wentworth Institute of Technology to continue my education in architecture. After a semester at Wentworth, I'd had it with beams and columns and decided to change majors and study physical education. Again, my parents were concerned. Although I enjoyed architecture, my passion was sports and teaching. For the next 3 years, I studied physical education at Bridgewater State College. It was a college then. And I received my bachelor's degree in physical education with a concentration in exercise physiology. I eventually became certified in education and began my career as a physical education teacher and coach at Silver Lake. Although my path was not a traditional one, and it took me 7 years, 3 colleges, and various student loans, I eventually found success. Success is defined as a favorable or desired outcome, and can also be defined as the attainment of wealth, favor, or eminence. What will your path to success look like? Will you change majors or careers? How many times will you fail before you succeed? The answer to these questions are not nearly as important as how you react in times of adversity. Charlie Chaplin, the iconic actor, filmmaker, and composer, once said, "Failure is unimportant. It takes courage to make a fool of yourself." Your path, like mine, may be messy. You may fail multiple times before you succeed. But based on my personal experiences, I know that each one of your challenges and failures will make you stronger. As I look back on my journey, I think about missed opportunities and fear of failure. Don't let fear get in the way of your success. Take risks, have no regrets, and have the courage to take advantage of all the opportunities afforded to you. In the words of Mark Twain, 20 years from now, you'll be more disappointed by the things you didn't do than by the ones you did. As graduates, you have attained what you set out to do several years ago when you began your educational journey. And now you stand before family and friends, celebrating the first of many successes. If there's anything the last few years have taught you, it's that you are resilient. I am confident that when faced with adversity, you will find a new path to success. Finally, remember to take a moment today and thank the people that helped get you here. We all wish you the very best in your future, and congratulations. I would now like to invite our senior class officers to the podium to address the class of 2022. Class Secretary, Isabella DeMorelis. Class Treasurer, Madison Prado. Publicity Coordinator, Claudia Pierce. Vice President, Gabriella Tabaji. And the Class of 22 President, Thomas Aiken.
Good morning, Mr. Neef, Mr. Schultz, Mr. Antel, Carver School Committee members, Carver Middle High School teachers and staff, dignitaries, family, friends, and members of the community. On the behalf of the fellow graduates, I would like to welcome you all to the commencement of the class of 2022. My name is Isabella DeMorelis, secretary for the graduating class, and I'm honored to be able to speak to you all today. To my classmates, we've journeyed through elementary school, middle school, and high school together, and our time here is over. It's the end of a decade, but the start of a new age. After today, we'll be all heading down our own separate paths. Regardless of the path we take, we'll all share one common ground, the moment we hold right now. Let us take this all in. The class of 2022, standing here in our caps and gowns, each of us knowing the many challenges we faced as a group and the individual struggles we fought to get us here to this moment. Our teachers, standing here to send us off and wish us well, our families beaming with pride, our administration here to offer us words of wisdom, and our community ready to honor and celebrate our accomplishments. We may all be going our own separate ways, but let's be present in this final moment together. Please welcome our class vice president, Gabby Tabaji.
Hello, I apologize in advance that you may see some tears, but we all know it's a very emotional day. I would like to share some advice written by the author, Dr. Seuss. When something bad happens, you have three choices. You can either let it define you can let it destroy you, or you can let it strengthen you. Through thick and thin, we have survived these 4 years. Even though COVID-19 tried to destroy our high school experience, we have worked hard not to let it define who we are as a class. As a class, we are stronger than we entered as ninth graders, and though we missed out on a lot as a class, we worked hard to piece together a senior year that would remember forever. Our first event was heading up to spend the day in Boston and enjoy a ride on the duck boats. Who remembers Black Swan? I can still see him walking through Faneuil Hall. Next was our senior dinner dance. It was a little hard to dance on the floor when it was full of sand. You know who I'm talking about. COVID had an effect on homecoming 2021. In order to dance and follow protocols, we had to order a dance floor and a tent to create outside. After it was all set up and decorated, I remember getting a text as me and Claudia came back from a soccer game saying, "This isn't good, guys." When we arrived at the gym, we saw Mr. Rota holding on for dear life as the tent was trying to fly away. This spring, many of us got to head down to Florida for Grad Bash. What a magical place. At night, when we walked back to our rooms, all I could see is two Jedis battling. Thanks Matt Stone and Ryan Mazzilli for making that a memory. Finally, after 2 years, we got to celebrate prom. Not only was it a night to remember, but the next day was something else. COVID strikes again. Yes, our numbers went up, but we didn't let that break our spirit. Our elementary walkthrough was so much fun, seeing all the little faces full with excitement as they see the graduating class of 2022 walking through their halls. Finishing off the year with our cookout and class day celebration, we got to celebrate all our accomplishments we have made. Now looking at this past year, it finally brings us to this day. Life may give us different circumstances or situations, but what truly makes us all the same is we are all crusaders and we grow stronger when faced with adversity. Thank you for the class memories 2022. I would like to invite our class treasurer, Maddie Parada, to give her remarks.
Today, I want to thank some of the most influential people of our high school careers, the teachers of Carver Middle High School. Our teachers at this school are special to each graduate here today in some way. Most of us have a special connection with a teacher in this building, and that relationship is what has helped us reach this milestone. To complete this journey full of ups and downs that is called high school, we need a source of inspiration and motivation. And here are some teachers the class of 2022 would like to thank. Personally, I would like to say thank you to Mr. Rota for always welcoming me into his classroom, even if I didn't have him during that class period, or at all this year for that matter. A thank you to Mrs. Kilnap for always truly caring about everyone, and personally for supporting not only my academic career, but my athletic career. I think I speak for the whole AP Calculus class when I say thank you to Mrs. Young, who pushed us past our limits and always challenged us so we could reach a new potential. And so senioritis couldn't get the best of us. A thank you to Mrs. Markram for caring about our well-being inside and outside the classroom. A thank you to Mrs. McIntosh for always being an approachable and welcoming person and supporting her students in their learning no matter what. And a thank you to Mrs. Waitner. Even though her AP Bio students suffered through the class, she is a teacher who cares for her students on academic and personal levels. For each of us, there is at least one teacher who we will remember forever because of the impact they have left on us. Because of the teachers at Carver Middle High School, us graduates get to walk across the stage today and start the new chapters of our lives. Please let me introduce Claudia Pierce, our class publicity coordinator.
Good morning, everyone. The past 7 years at Carver Middle High School were by no means easy, but today seems to be one of the hardest days of my school career. It's looking back and realizing that we are here at the end. But today marks the start of new beginnings and going our separate ways. As my classmates have expressed, we bonded together as a class. This is most likely the last time we will all be together as a group. Many of us will cherish the friendships made at Carver for the rest of our lives. Those relationships are what kept most of us going throughout high school, especially during the toughest moments. After school, you could hear the rally noises coming from Mr. Aruda's room as esports members cheered each other on. The girls' winter and spring track teams fought together to be named the Tobin Division champions in both seasons. Mrs. Markram's ping pong pals bonded over ping pong. Mrs. Young's calc class conquered while we survived the class together. Today we get to celebrate the struggles we defeated, celebrate the efforts we put forth to our academic and athletic success. Though there may have been several times where we thought we wouldn't survive senioritis, we made it. We found ways to fight what was thrown at us, both mental and physical, and for that I must congratulate us all. Wherever our future may take us, I want to wish the best of luck to my fellow classmates. I know we will all do great things and continue to come any obstacle thrown at us. Please welcome our class president, Tommy Aiken, to the podium for our final remarks as your student government.
All right. It's a bit sunny out, but I'm gonna take off my glasses. Oh, well, there goes my paper. Nope, still got it. All right, we're gonna try something here. I'm feeling a little nervous, so I'm gonna do this thing where I breathe in slowly and breathe out slowly. I want you guys to do it with me on three. One, two, three. All right, see, that's presidency, right there. All right, let's get this started. Hello, my name's Tom Aitken, and I'd like to address you guys one last time as the senior class and soon-to-be man in the real world. I want to start off by saying thank you for everyone that has gotten us here today, and more so to the ones that have gotten us here today. You guys have been here for us when we need you the most, and today you watch it all come together. Now you guys want you to look around, find someone, maybe a friend, family member, a teacher that has gotten you here today. Just give them a nod, sign of thanks, show you appreciate them. Those people for me, of course, are my family, my mom, my dad, and my sister. I can never thank you guys enough. You put in so much work to get me where I am and who I am today, and it shows. On that topic, I would like to share some wisdom that my mom has given me throughout the years that I found the most impactful. Now I know I'm one of the luckiest people alive to have someone like my mother in my corner of the ring. She's one of the smartest people you'll ever meet, and her accomplishments show for that. She would build her own successful real estate company from the ground up, and in a time where she couldn't work due to worldwide pandemic, she would decide to go back to college to further her business expertise at nowhere other than Harvard University. Yet, in all of that, whenever I'm in need of advice, she would always seem to be there for me just when I need her the most, just to say the right thing. She's good like that. She always has my back whenever I need her the most. Now, one phrase in particular that I would hear the most was a question. Is this who you are? Is this who you want to be? The second half of that question I always found to be the heavy hitter. No matter if I was 5 years old or 18, she would always remind me who I am and who I want to be is not that far from reach or gone in time. She would always say if the answer isn't yes to both of those questions, you have to be willing to put in the work and time to make it yes. No matter what point you are at in your life, that question can always have a different answer, and just the same, it can never be too late to be who you want to be. I stand here today in front of all of you, not telling you my story or how we got here. I hope by now you guys already know that. But I stand here to look what I like doing the most and what so many people in my life did for me, which I am ever so grateful for. I stand here to look to help everyone in this crowd who is hearing me speak learn something that maybe they didn't expect to learn from a high school graduate. Because I believe the strongest attribute to good advice is it's universal. I can tell it to a crowd of high school graduates or a crowd of people that have already lived through the majority of their life. Because it's never too late in life to work towards who you want to be, to be able to say yes to both questions. Now next year I will be attending the University of Massachusetts, Boston. In my application essay, I was asked to discuss an accomplishment, event, or realization that has started personal growth and new understanding of others. That new understanding for me was when I learned the value of perspective. The word perspective is defined as a particular attitude or way of regarding something, point of view. Now I feel understanding perspective is a very complex thing that I can't even say I fully understood, yet here I am defining the word. I believe the root of understanding perspective is understanding and seeing the bigger picture. On average, Americans live to see the age of 77. In this moment in time, the class of 22, we have lived through almost 1/4 of our natural lives. Understanding perspective is understanding we have just gotten started. Now I know the cliche of saying graduating is just the beginning of everything. Well, I say graduating isn't that, but the next chapter in your book of life. So go out there and make your book something worth reading. Thank you.
While they're sitting down, I'll clean up a little bit here. I like the breathing thing, Tommy. I'm going to try that. Thank you. I see that. Don't worry, Allison. I still have your speech. But a nice round of applause for our senior class officers. At this time, I'd like to welcome Superintendent Scott Neef to join me in presenting the two highest awards for our class of 2022, the valedictorian and the salutatorian. if I could ask Dominic Macrina, the salutatorian of the class of 2022, to join us on stage for a few words.
Becoming a salutatorian has been a long journey with education, starting when I was very young. It started with the mindset I have developed around school, which makes it more than just school. It has become educating myself. Every skill developed and all the knowledge gained can help me to better myself. This mindset I can credit significantly to my family, especially my parents. All the late nights they would make me finish my homework when it was the last thing I wanted to do. They pushed me hard enough to encourage me, but were always understanding and gave me enough independence to not be overbearing. I know we all have our parents, our family, and our supporters to thank the most for the place we have ended up in today. Bye-bye. Don't forget to take a moment to thank your supporters today. Thank you.
And finally, I would like to welcome Allison Strojan, the valedictorian of the class of 2022.
Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the graduation for the class of 2022. I would like to personally welcome my dad, my mom, my sister Emily, and my grandma sitting right in the front row. I would also like to welcome all the families of the graduates and also the dignitaries here today. Thank you, families, students, and faculty for putting up with us since the start of our lives. That takes a lot of patience. I would just like to say to my class of 2022, guys, we made it. I'm proud of us, and I'm sure all your family and friends are too. As we all venture off into the new world of adulting, we will take with us the memories we gained throughout high school. One of my funniest memories that happened this year was when Jay and I were voted the couple that never was, while simultaneously being voted homecoming king and queen. Definitely didn't expect that. All of us have had many experiences this year, though. By participating in sports, internships, other after-school activities, and even regular classes, we have learned skills essential to our futures. As Dr. Seuss once said, only you can control your future. He means that only you can decide which actions to take and what decisions to make to develop your future. Some of us are heading off to college, and some of us are going to get a job and start working after high school. And some of us might go into the military, and some of us might take a different course of action. Although all of us are becoming active members of society, we're all doing it in our own way and making our own choices to create and shape our futures. Now, many of you may not know this, but I'm sure some of you do. I'm a person who likes to write poetry, so I wrote a poem for you. Like hatchlings who have jumped out of the nest, we all must now learn to fly. We, for sure, can only do our best with our knowledge and will to try. Some of us might fall to the ground before we can glide and soar, while some of us may have a wobbly flap before reaching great heights and more. Some of us may fly back home, and some of us may fly far away. Some of us may simply roam, and some of us may find our own unique way. Although we'll all move along in life, and we'll all change with time, we'll always remember our roots and all the obstacles we had to climb. So I wish you all luck in your life, your adventures, whatever they may be. I hope none of you experience any rife and glide in life with. As you continue on in your lives, you may become very busy facing new challenges you expected you would face and overcoming different obstacles you didn't expect to have to face. But remember to take care of yourselves. You may be on your own, but you have the knowledge, skills, family, friends, teachers, professors, and more to support you. From there, you can take off and explore this world and make your future your own. As Dr. Seuss once said, you're on your own, and you know what you know, and you are the one who'll decide where to go. Thank you.
One last final applause for all of our student speakers and our valedictorian and salutatorian. At this time, I'd like to welcome Superintendent of Schools, Mr. Scott Neef, to the podium to address the graduates.
Good morning. I'm so happy to be here today. Congratulations to the members of the class of 2022, their family and friends. I'd like to thank everyone here for the role that you play in the lives of our graduates. From family and friends who've always been there for each one of you, to our teachers and staff who supported you all along the way, to Mr. Schultz, Mr. Antel, Mrs. Cabral, for their leadership throughout the school year. 3 of your 4 years have been impacted by the COVID-19 pandemic. This year, my daughter, Alex, earned her master's degree. All 3 years of her graduate program were affected by the pandemic. They were pandemic years. Also, I'm very lucky, very fortunate. My son, Tim, is earning his bachelor's degree this year. And like you, 3 of his 4 years in college have been impacted by the COVID-19 pandemic. I wonder what the impact of the past 3 years will be on each of you, on my kids, and really on each one of us here today. But by nature, I'm an optimist. I'm a glasses half full type of guy. So despite the realities of loss and stress and challenges presented to all of us through the pandemic, I believe the graduating class of 2022 will persevere and come out stronger than ever. Ralph Waldo Emerson said, "What lies behind us and what lies before us are tiny matters compared to what lies within us." What lies within you, class of 2022? I think I might know a little bit about what lies within you. Courage, character, love, a spirit of charity, a dedication to friends and family, a set of skills. Empowered learners can do anything. And I believe today's ceremony is the affirmation, the final seal, that you are all empowered learners and that you all can do anything. So class of 2022, I want to give you a couple things to think about that will help bring out the greatness that lies within each one of you. Number one, always have a positive mindset. We can't and we shouldn't waste time and mental energy on negativity and uncertainty. It's the mental construct of our activities, not the activities themselves, that defines our reality. What does that mean? It means your mindset, as you do whatever it is you're doing, is as important, if not more important, than what you actually do. Having a positive mindset at all times is the foundation. It allows you to tap into your inner strength to achieve your dreams. Number two. Imagine the possibilities. Imagine what your life, your job, your relationships could and should be. You have to dream about what your life will become. One of the most famous representations of the concept of imagining the possibilities is Dr. Martin Luther King's I Have a Dream speech. Dr. King imagined the possibility of what he wanted the world to look like one day. A day I hope we are moving ever closer to. A day I think you, the class of 2022, will help us achieve. On the steps of the Lincoln Memorial in 1963, Dr. King said, "I have a dream that one day this nation will rise up and live out the true meaning of its creed. We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal. I have a dream that my four children will one day live in a nation where they are judged by the content of their character, not by the color of their skin. Today, I ask you, the class of 2022, to imagine the possibilities of your future. The possibilities that you represent are innumerable. I hope I am still here in 30 and maybe even 50 years to see all the things you've accomplished." Number 3, fall up. As kids, we all learn to ride a bike. And the reality is, when you learn to ride a bike, you fall down. And what did you do when you fell off your bike? You got back up. As Thomas Edison said, "I have not failed, I've just found 10,000 ways that don't work." That's the epitome of falling up. You will have challenging days, you have days when you fall down. But remember, people who are happy and resilient and achieve success always get back up on their bike and they fall up. Number 4, build strong alliances. No one achieves happiness and success alone. Is a result in the support of many. All of us are ultimately responsible for the directions our lives take, but none of us could be here today without the help and support of others. The people who build the strongest alliances and the strongest networks are often the most successful, so build strong alliances. Many of you have already established your networks. I encourage you to maintain your friendships that you have and strengthen the alliances you already have, but always seek to build new ones. They will help you as you strive to achieve your personal goals. So as you move forward from today, you move forward into the next phase of your life, remember and embrace having a positive mindset, imagining the possibilities of what your life will and should become, always fall up, and build strong alliances. In doing this, you will bring out the greatness that lies within each one of you. It's with pride that I serve as the superintendent of the Carver Public Schools. Thank you, best of luck in the future, and congratulations to each and every one of you.
Thank you, Mr. Neef. Gonna adjust this a little bit. At this time, I would like to ask the class of 2022 to please rise. Press the bell has to ring one more time. As the principal of Carver Middle High School, I attest that the members of the class of 2022 who stand here before you have fulfilled all of the local and state requirements for graduation from this institution as stipulated by the Carver School Committee. I present to you the class of 2022. At this time, Mr. Antel will now call the roll, and Mr. Neef and I will award diplomas. You may be seated.
Sorry, I'm short. Okay, before we dispense diplomas, I'd like to inform our graduates the procedures for entering and exiting the stage since we haven't had an opportunity to rehearse. So as each row is invited to stand, they'll assemble to the right of the stage, my left. When your name is called, you'll walk on the stage to receive your diploma and pause for a photograph of Mr. Schultz. You will then exit the stage to my right, your left, and you will return to your seat. And then you'll remain standing. As the first row sits, that's the cue for the second row to assemble, rise and assemble, and so on. Okay? You ready? Okay, first row, please stand and assemble to the right of the stage. Kevin Michael Aducci. Thomas Joseph Aiken. James Cooper Bellevue. Juliana Nicole Bent. Josiah Thomas Berry. Raymond Lewis Boudiette. Braden Anthony Boyle. Libby Mae Camardella. Tyler Shane Carpenter. Autumn Marie Carvalho. Matthew Stephen Coletta. Daniel Hunter Camo. Allison Charlie Connor. Isley Jose Costa. Angel Marie Crane. Michael Gerald Crump. Joshua Michael DeCourt. Isabella Beatriz De Morales. May sit, row two, please rise and assemble by the stage. Keely Shea Demers. Aaron Stephen Druin. Sorry. Druin. Andrew Riley DeShulo. Connor James Filming. Callie Sari Gilbert. Bailey Marie Giorgio. Jeremy Stetson Griffith Jr. Gianna Kim Hernandez. Zachary James Aronimo. Abigail Marie Johnson. Aiden Christopher Jordan. Madison Florence Kell. Nathan Matthew King. Kaylee Alyssa Lane. Joshua Paul Lucas. Dominic Clark Macrina. Anya Eleanor Manning. Daniel Joseph Marois. Okay, row two may sit. Row three, please be upstanding and assemble next to the stage. Jesse Trina Marshall Hewlett. Ryan John Mazzilli. Ava Virginia McElroy. Justin Daniel Minahan. Isaac Maurice Morris Jr. William Michael Murray. Chloe Elizabeth Nickerson. Keegan Christopher O'Connor. Claudia Ilona Pierce. Robert Daniel Perry III. J. Stephen Peters. Nicholas Floyd Peterson. Havana Jade Pina. John Joseph Pollock. Madison Mary Prado. Jamie Lynn Robinson. Ryan Matthew Santa. Kyle James Schott. Row three may sit. Row four, please stand and assemble next to the stage. Matthew Derek Simmons. Olivia Grace Simmons. No. Olivia Nancy Sontag. Kylie Janice Spiewakowski. Matthew Douglas Stone. Allison May Strogeny. Connor Theodore Tate. Gabriella Marissa Tabaji. Amber Louise Thomas. Brandon Giovanni Zanaboni.
I think we're done here. No, we can't go yet. You may be seated. This time I'd like to ask Mr. Thomas Aiken to please come to the front of the class and leave the diploma. Down front. Actually, come on up, I'm sorry. He's going to lead us, the class of 2022, in the symbolic act of moving their tassels from the right to the left.
Come on, Mr. Aiken.
Everyone stand up again. On the count of three, we are going to move the tassels from right to left. From right to left. You guys got this. I'm going to count down from three to one. On one, we're all going to do it. It's going to look amazing. Three, two, one. We're there!
Please remain standing. This time we're going to prepare for our students for the traditional cap toss. Spread out a little bit. You don't need 6 feet, but that's fine. On the count of three, we will ask all students to toss their caps in the air for a celebration. Tommy, this is my show. On the count of three. One, two, three. The class of 2022. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise and acknowledge the class of 2022. Students, remain where you are in your seats. We're going to get ready for our procession. Class of 2022, if you could please have a seat. We're going to get ready to, with our end of the celebration, processional. If I could ask Sydney Sheehan, class of 2023 president, to come forward and rise our students. Faculty, staff, and dignitaries, I now invite you to lead the procession as you leave the stadium to form your walk to welcome the class of 2022. Yeah, that's you, sorry. Sneak, I'm gonna...